Nathan Birch is building his dream home northwest of Sydney. As always, he's thinking ahead. There'll be plenty of bedrooms, a pool and backyard big enough to let the kids run around.
I wanted to have a nice place that I'd be proud to call home when I have a wife and children one day.
But it's not Nathan's first home, or even his second. In fact, he's bought, or is in the process of buying, more than 170 pieces of real estate.
I'm quite excited about investing at the age of 13, but couldn't sign a contract. My formal training in real estate is saving up money, working hard, and buying properties.
I earn over $2 million a year in rent. My positive cash flow is over $500,000 a year just on rental incomes.
I've heard about the property bubble for the last 12 years since buying my first property. There's always money to be made out there.
Every year, about 500,000 properties are bought and sold across Australia, and the issue of who can or can't afford them is a hot topic.
Even as a cabinet minister, sometimes it's hard to pay a Sydney mortgage.
But recent research reveals the Harbour City is almost a no-go zone for first home buyers. As an 18-year-old, Nathan knew the best property he could afford was nowhere near the inner city. So he scrimped and saved for this one in Sydney's far west.
I used to staple my socks together, work two full-time jobs, eat for a dollar a day. I do believe I sacrificed, you know, a good chunk of my youth.
It started a journey that's led him to a property portfolio worth an estimated $30 million at the age of 30.
I guess it was my apprenticeship on life, this property here. I had $35,000 of savings, added a lot of sweat equity into it, a lot of nails in my hands and scars which are still there on my hands today. As soon as I finished doing the renovations to it, it was valued at $350,000, so I'd made $100,000. Pretty hard to save up $100,000 at an 18-year-old kid.
From humble beginnings in Sydney's west, his real estate interests now stretch across three states, as Nathan uses the equity in each successive property to buy more homes. But it's not a strategy that works for everyone.
We saw it happen in Australia, late 80s, early 90s. Housing took a dip. People had too much borrowings, too much debt from the bank, and they suffered. Nathan Birch has been fortunate. He's had a period of rising property prices and falling interest rates, and that is a great wealth-creating duo.
For Nathan, buying homes where renters cover the mortgage has worked, most recently on the Gold Coast.
It's where other people want to live and it's affordable housing, and looking and speaking with all the real estate agents in the area, there isn't any properties for rent, so, you know, it's always a good sign.
More than a decade after he signed up for his first mortgage, Nathan's been successful enough to set up his own property investment business, and the lessons he learned as a teenager are still the ones that guide him.
A lot of people out there want to have everything now, their nice four-bedroom, two-storey house in a nice family area that they can live in and invite their friends over for a cocktail party. I didn't go on tiki tours and travel the world or anything like that, but I do have financial independence where I can do what I want on my terms today. Upside down through to the other side.